entry, minor entry. As I told you, A will go to the leaf node, A will be a leaf node, and B will also be a leaf node. Therefore, it will be like this. A, B, and A plus B. Plus is an operator, it will be an intermediate node. Now you can see that this is the binary tree with three nodes. This is an intermediate node. This operator is an intermediate node, and A and B are leaf nodes. So A plus B can be represented in this format. Okay. Now, suppose I want to represent C plus D. So this is C, D. You can see this is C plus D. So the second tree corresponds to C plus D. So this is A plus, this is this, the left tree, the left binary tree corresponds to A plus B, and the tree on this right side, this one corresponds to C plus D. Now let us think of another expression, that is where I want to represent A plus B into C plus D. This is to be represented. Let us assume this is to be represented. So what happened? You have these two trees. This corresponds to A plus B, and this corresponds to C plus D, and they have to be multiplied. Therefore, from these intermediate nodes, we'll make another intermediate node, which is multiplication. Now, the whole tree corresponds to, so this is A plus B into C plus D. Okay, this is A plus B into C plus D. Okay. So that is it. So now you can see that here you require a bracket. Whereas if you represent this mathematical expression using a binary tree, brackets are not required. That is, the precedence of operation will be automatically clumped in. It will automatically come. You don't have to incorporate the brackets. Braces are not required if you want to represent a mathematical expression. Okay. So, now let us see how this is to be done, how it will look, that is how the precedences are coming. With two small examples, we'll see it. Suppose I want to represent this one. A plus B into C. This is one case, A plus B into C. Whereas, A plus B into C. These are two situations. Here, A plus B is to be added first and then it is to be multiplied by C. Whereas here, A plus B into C is to be multiplied and then A is to be added to that. Both are different. Okay. A plus B into C, here if you want, you can put a bracket, but bracket is not required even otherwise. Okay, A plus B into C, A plus B into C. Now, let us see how these expressions will differ. What is the difference between these two mathematical expressions if they are represented using binary trees? So, again, here A plus B is to be represented first. That is the first thing. A, B. So this is A plus B. Right? This is A plus B. Now, this is to be multiplied by C. Therefore, you have another operand C. And this are to be multiplied. Therefore, it will be like this. So, this binary tree corresponds to A plus B into C. A plus B into C. Okay. Now let us look at the other one. B A plus B into C. So, as far as the second case is concerned, it will be slightly different. So, because we want to first multiply B into C. So, B into C has been multiplied. B into C has been multiplied and then A is to be added. So here you have A, and A is to be added with A in A plus B in this. So now here you have the plus operator. Now you see this is equal to A plus B into C. Okay, A plus B into C. Fine. So this is also, so here you can see that, here you can see that you do not require brackets. Brackets are not required for incorporating the precedence of an expression. So that is the advantage of, what is it, by representation of mathematical expression or expression trees. Expression trees do not require brackets to be stored. Automatically, that is the way how it is done. That is, the precedence are incorporated. Precedence of operations are incorporated. Now, let us take a comparatively longer mathematical expression and then let us analyze, let us traverse these expression trees in pre-order, in-order and post-order and see what is going to be the outcome. Suppose you have a mathematical expression like this, A plus B into B plus D divided by E by F exponentiation G into H. Okay, suppose this is an expression. A plus B into C plus D divided by, okay, E by F exponentiation G into H. This mathematical expression is to be represented using an expression. So each component let us try to integrate. First is let us try to make A plus B. A, B, and this is A plus B. A plus B. Okay. So this is A plus B. Now C plus B. A plus B, this is A plus B and this is C plus D. Now these two are to be multiplied. It is done. So now we have got A plus B into C plus D, that is there. Okay. Now we have to do E by F. This is our E by F and then G into H. Okay. Now G into H is also there. Now this is to be exponential, that is this exponentiation this. Therefore, it will be like this. This is E by F exponentiation G into H. So this part is also there. Now you can see that we have done this part and this part. Now this is to be divided by that. Therefore, now the whole tree corresponds to our expression. That is, this tree corresponds to our expression A plus B into C plus D divided by E by F exponentiation G into H. Okay. So this is an expression tree corresponding to the expression given. Now, let us see what will happen. What is going to be the outcome if we visit or if we traverse this expression tree in pre-order, in-order and post-order. Okay. So, this expression is there. Right? This expression is there. Let me call it as E is equal to some expression. Expression is equal to, this is the expression. Now, this expression we are going to traverse in pre-order, in-order and post-order. Okay? We are going to traverse in pre-order, in-order and post-order. First, let us traverse this in-order fashion. In-order traversal. In-order traversal means, we will be traversing left. Okay? We will be traversing left, node, right. Okay? In-order is left, then node, then right. That is in order. Fine. So here, if I traverse this expression tree in order fashion, first left is to be visited, therefore you will get A, then plus, okay, left, node, right, A plus B, left, node, right. So A plus B, then you are getting star A plus B into C plus D. Okay? A, left side is over, then this can be visited A plus B. So left side is over, now we will be visiting this. Okay, A, left side is over, we visit this plus, then right side A plus B, left side is over, then we are visiting this. So A plus B star. Fine. Then C plus D, left side is over, then we will be visiting slash. Okay. Then we will be visiting what? E divided by F. Okay. Then exponentiation. Then G star H. You will find, that is, if I visit this expression tree in order fashion, you always get the infix expression. You get the same expression. You can see, it is equal to A plus B into C plus D divided by E by F exponentiation G into H without bracket. That's all. So, if you traverse an expression tree in order fashion, you get the infix expression. Equivalent infix expression. That is why it is in order. In order and infix. There is a relation. That is why the name was given. In order. Now let us see what you will get if you traverse the tree in pre-order. In pre-order, you have to always traverse root, left, right. Okay. So suppose I traverse this tree in pre-order. What we will get? This is pre-order. In pre-order, we will be visiting node, okay, node and then left, right. Node, left, right. So what we will get here? Let us see. Pre is node, then left and then right. So here you will get first slash, then I will get star, then I will get plus, then A, then I get B. Okay. Node, again node, left is over, then therefore I can write, do right also. Okay. So star, then slash, star, plus A, then B. Then come to this side. Okay. Then here again I will get plus, fine, slash, star, plus A, B. Again I get plus C, D. Then come to this side. Again I will get exponentiation, division, E, F, star, G, and H. This is what I get. So if you travel the tree now in, that is in pre-order, you will find that you get prefix expression. Okay? You get the equivalent prefix expression of the given expression. Similarly, if you travel the tree in post-order, you will get the postfix expression. Let us see what is going to be the expression, postfix expression. Suppose I traveled this particular expression tree in post order. What is post order first of all? Post order, it should be left, right and then nodes. Okay. Therefore, you will get left, right, so A, B plus, right? Then C, D plus, then you get star. Right? Then you get E, F division, G, H star, then exponentiation and then division. This is what we get. If you travel this expression tree in post order, you get the equivalent postfix expression. Okay? So, once an mathematical expression is stored using an expression tree, first advantage is you do not require brackets at all. Brackets are not required to incorporate the precedence. Without brackets, you can store any mathematical expression using any expression can be stored using an expression tree. That is the first thing. Brackets are not required. It saves space. And similarly, you can get the equivalent infix, prefix or postfix by suitably traversing the tree. You get the, if you traverse the expression tree in order, you get infix. If you traverse the tree in pre-order, you get the prefix. And if you traverse the tree in post-order, you get the equivalent postfix expression. Okay. So that is it. Now, let us see how we can construct a tree if you are provided with the sequences. That is, suppose you are given a binary tree, you can travel the tree and find the pre-order sequence, in-order sequence, post-order sequence, etc., etc. You can find. Now, suppose you have not been given the tree. You have a tree is there. And if that tree is traversed in pre-order, this is going to be the sequence. If that tree is traversed in order, this is going to be the sequence. That is, you will be given the sequence only. You do not know what is a tree. You will be given the pre-order traversal sequence. You will be given the in-order traversal sequence. Or you will be given the post-order traversal sequence. From that sequence, can we find what is the tree? Is it possible? Let us see. That is, suppose you are provided with the two sequences. That is, suppose you are given the pre-order sequence and the in-order sequence. These two sequences of a particular tree is given. That is, there is a tree. But if that tree is traversed in pre-order, this is the sequence. If that tree is traversed in order, this is the sequence. Now, can you find the tree? Let us see. Fine. So, for that, we'll try. That is, we'll note two sequences. From that, we'll try to create a tree. What can be the algorithm? We'll think of. Fine. So here you are given two sequences. One is a pre-order sequence. And you have been given an in-order sequence also. Okay? And the pre-order sequence is, let it be A, B, D, E, A, B, D, E, F, C, G, H, J, L, K. This is the pre-order sequence. Okay. Now, the in-order sequence is D, B, F, E, D, B, F, E, A, G, C, A, G, C, L, J, L, J, H, K. Okay. So these two sequences are given to you. That is, there is a tree. If the tree is traversed in pre-order, this is the sequence. And if this if the tree is traversed in order, this is going to be the sequence. And what is the tree? That we have to find out. Okay. Let us see how this can be found. For that, the first thing we should know, what are these algorithms? Fine. So the sequences are there. Sequences have been given to you. You should be able to analyze these sequences. Fine. First thing is, if you traverse any tree in pre-order fashion, the first node you visit, pre-order is what? What is pre-order? Pre-order is the pre-order traversal corresponds to node left and right. That is pre-order. Okay? Whereas in order is left, node, right. Okay. Now by looking at this, you will be able to make a judgment. Okay. Now you look at the pre-order traversal. In pre-order traversal, we always visit the node first. So you can see, in pre-order, you will find that A. So, A must be the root node of the tree. That is the first node. Okay. A must be the root node of the tree. Now, that is identified. A is the root node. Now, what are all the nodes on the left side of this A, and what are all the nodes on the right side of A? How do we justify this? It's a very simple thing. Again, you look at the in-order. In order, first is you should visit all the left nodes, then only you can visit a node, and then you go to the right node. So you can see, in order, you look at the position of A.